Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be talking all about journaling, how to get into it, how to genuinely enjoy it and stay consistent with it. All of the tips I have for beginners, because you guys always ask me on Instagram and I thought it was about time I gave you that video. And most importantly, I'm going to be exposing some of my old journal entries, give you guys a good idea of kind of like how I journal, how I use it. And also they're just really interesting and have a lot of gossip in them. So stay tuned for that. Through a few of my favorite tips on how you can actually get into it. So number one is that everybody has a different reason to journal. You've got to figure out what yours is. Now you can either choose one of these or you can kind of create a mix of them, which is what I do. So number one is to use it as a daily journal slash like daily log, and this is where you can just rant and ramble for pages and pages. You kind of talk about everything that happened in your day, down to like what you ate, who you saw, where you went, and this is a really good way to bank memories, but also just dump, like do a thought dump of every single thing that happened in your day. And I really recommend doing this before you go to sleep every night if this is how you want to do it, because it just means you're releasing everything that's happened to you in that day, good or bad, and you're not harboring any thoughts or any stresses when you go to sleep. Number two is a manifestation journal. Now a common practice is that some people will have one journal, for example, which is their daily log. This is where they kind of write down everything that's happening, use it as a kind of dear diary thing. And then they have a completely separate one where they write their manifestations. Now, you don't have to do this, but I personally recommend doing it, because when you have one journal that is committed to anything I write in here, I am manifesting, you are putting that energy onto the journal, right? But then if you are also writing in there everything that's happening in your day, and you're ranting about things, and you're using it as an emotional release, and maybe you're writing down some bad stuff that happened to you, you might be also unintentionally manifesting more of that bad stuff to happen. So I would recommend keeping the two things separate. Number three is use it as a goal tracker. Now this is what I started doing. For reference, this is my first ever journal. It's a moleskin journal, both of these are. I started this in June 2020 and wrote in it up until December 2021 because I wasn't staying that consistent with it. This is just kind of like a daily diary thing, just funny ranting, daily log stuff. But for 2022, I got a brand new journal, and this is actually like a once a day journal kind of thing. So I'll go to a blank page. Each day has the date in the corner, so you can only really fill up one page a day, as opposed to this where like one log would take up five pages. And this is my goal tracker. So I wanted something short and concise, can only fill up one page. And finally, the last common journal practice is a gratitude practice. Now, this is a great way to journal for those of you who don't really have a lot of time, you don't think journaling is really for you, but you kind of still want to try it. This would literally only take you 2 minutes. It just involves writing a few little lines once per day. I'm grateful for 1, 2, 3. You know, just write down 3 to 5 things every single day that you're grateful for. It means that you're putting out positivity, you're vibrating at a high level, but you're not taking up too much of your time, and it's not a huge thing to commit to. Okay, so next, let's talk about how you can stay consistent with it and genuinely enjoy it. This is so, so important. You should never look at journaling as a chore. First way to do this is to figure out your preferences and what is gonna make it easiest for you. So this might be journaling once a day, but just a few sentences, 5 minutes, that's it. It could be journaling once a week and doing a whole detailed summary of your week, which takes a few pages, but it just means you don't have to be that consistent with it and remember it on a daily basis. It could be journaling one sentence per day. It could be journaling how you're feeling in the morning and then coming back to it at night and writing another sentence on how you feel at night. But then you can also get specific journals. This is a mindfulness journal and it's a day and night reflection journal. The journal that you buy is also so important, whether that be in size because you want to write a lot or a little, or whether you want to do a completely plain journal like I do to just kind of have a thought dump of everything, or to buy ones that have templates in them already. There are so many different templates you can look at. You really just got to explore the different journals out there. In terms of consistency, I really recommend setting in your phone a daily repeated timer. I currently have a repeated calendar alert. So every single day at 10 p.m., my calendar will come up with a notification that says journal reflection, and that means I will never forget. I always know that's the last thing to do in my day. Another good way to make sure that you're genuinely enjoying it and staying consistent with it is to figure out your preferences in terms of, do you want to keep it simple, messy handwriting, just blur out everything onto a page, which is what I do, or do you want to be really creative with it? A lot of people are so creative with their journals. Some people use like washi tapes and different colored pens and highlighters and diagrams, and they like stick pictures in it whilst also writing about their day. And for those of you who are a little bit more artistic and want to have a creative outlet, then that's a really good way to journal as well, and it makes it a little bit more exciting. And finally, the most significant way to stay consistent with journaling and make sure you're genuinely enjoying it is to figure out the benefits that you're going to get from when you start your journaling practice. There are an abundance of benefits you gain from journaling. It's really about looking into those and which ones you want to have for yourself. Growth, healing, uncovering trauma, emotional support, keeping stress at bay, shadow work, reflecting on your current feelings so you can remain self-aware, and finally, obviously, law of attraction / manifestation, and like keeping track of your goals. To help you guys out, I'm currently going to switch to a screen which contains a bunch of journaling prompts on it. Feel free to screenshot. And now finally, let's talk about what I personally do in my journaling practice, if you guys want to get some inspiration from that, and then I will expose some of my journal entries to you guys as well at the end. Okay, so as I mentioned previously, in my first journal, which I got in 2020 and also used throughout 2021, this didn't really have much structure. It was a way for me to just ramble, have an emotional release, get a bunch of stuff out. 2020 was a bloody roller coaster for me. There was just so much happening. There is so much stuff in here about like breakups and exes and all of that stuff, but it's really interesting to read through for me because it just shows the journey, and because it starts in 2020 and then ends at 2021, it literally shows me being like heartbroken in 2020 to all of my happy entries in 2021 where I was starting on my self-love journey and taking myself on self-dates. But what I'm doing currently is obviously using it as a goal tracker because it's a one page a day thing with the dates written on. I just fill each page every single day. The bulk of each entry is, this is the work I did today, this is how I'm being productive, these are the goals I'm working towards, this is what I'm gonna do better tomorrow. And then every single entry always has at least three things that I'm grateful for and maybe a thing or two that I'm manifesting. Right, now, before this video ends, I'm gonna expose some of my old journal entries because they're very interesting. So this journal was started in June 2020. For reference, June 2020, I had just broken up with my boyfriend at the time. But it was a good breakup, like I wasn't heartbroken or anything. And it was also the time where my Instagram had been taking off at this point, and it was the time that I'd also just started my YouTube channel. Let's go to, this is Sunday, 7th of June, 2020, and I'm gonna read what I wrote, okay. Dear diary, today has been so wonderful in caps. I edited my entire second YouTube video and remade my intro, which was effort, but I actually prefer it now. I learned how affiliate links work, and I made the prettiest thumbnail for my PLC haul. Not gonna lie, I'm still nervous to upload it because I think it could have been better. Typical me, perfectionist. But I'm still only starting out, and I'll keep learning and improving as I go along. Yes, love that energy. Okay, here I mentioned two of my friends. Don't know if they'd want me to mention them, so I'm just gonna say blank here. Blank and blank FaceTimed me today, which was so sweet. We had a really nice catch up, laughed and made lots of plans for our second year of uni. Aww. They wanted to check up on me because of the breakup. This made me realize how unbothered I actually was by it. I'm not upset in the slightest. I feel good where I am, and being single for a while to make friends, memories, and achievements is the path I need to take at the moment. I did text blank, I'm talking about the guy I've just broken up with at this point. I did text blank to ask how he's doing. I really don't want to be his girlfriend, but I still care about him a lot, and I have been worrying about him, but he ignored both of my texts. I literally forgot all of this happened. Okay, here I'm talking about a brand, so I'm not gonna go too much into detail with this. On top of that, they are offering to pay me, and then basically I write down the amount, which I'm not gonna say, but it was like an incredibly low amount. Like, I massively undersold myself because I was just starting out. Oh my days, this is my first hashtag ad post on Instagram. I'm so happy and grateful. Manifestation is so real. After reading The Secret, that is the best book you can read to learn about manifestation, by the way. I really tried focusing on attracting money into my life, mainly through Instagram, as money is my only stress at the moment, and it worked. I know many other brands will now start approaching me with paid collaborations, and I'm ready to accept that money into my life. Okay, that might sound like a really weird sentence, but what that is a manifestation slash affirmation. Saying affirmations is a manifestation practice in itself. At this point, I had just started on Instagram. I've just written about my first collab with a brand that paid me a tinsy little bit of money. And I say, I know many other brands will now start approaching me with paid collaborations and I'm ready to accept that money into my life. I actually had no idea that any brands were gonna come and offer me any money. That could have been a complete one-off. I could have given up on the Instagram thing in a few months and my Instagram couldn't have grown whatsoever. But I decided to say that it was gonna happen anyway, to manifest it. And now here I am 2 years later, and I've worked with brands like ASOS and Jack Wills and Pretty Little Thing and Colgate. Life is good and I feel grateful 24/7. Everything is aligning for me right now. Once again, another affirmation, another manifestation technique in me writing that. Expressing gratitude for the blessings that were in my life at that point so I can attract even more. I'm also excited to invest more into my friendships. I want to do cute romantic stuff for my BFFs, like surprise picnics and watching the sunrise at the beach. A few weeks after this, I did put together a surprise picnic for my two best friends. Watching the sunrise at the beach is still on my bucket list. I still need to do that. And do stuff like that with them instead of boyfriends. I'm so glad I'm finally in this place. Love, heart. Okay, and then I wrote a list of some of the things I was grateful for on this day. Some things I'm grateful for. My best friends, my freedom, my mum, the comfortable life I have at home and my grandparents, my ability to drive. It's a bit of a random one, but you know, anything. You can be grateful for literally anything. My motivation at the moment, my social media growth, and financial abundance. No, well, let's go to 2021 now, because this is where there are like no breakups, no heartbreak, no boy drama. It's literally just me, myself, and I. Okay, so this is an entry from November 2021. Wow, so this was literally, what, 4 months ago now? Yeah, 6th of November 2021. Dear Diary, I'm so grateful, happy, and at peace. The storm has finally cleared up, and life is so good and full of blessings for me right now. I'm so thankful. I wish I could hug summer 2021 Tam right now and reassure her that everything will be okay. For those of you who don't know, summer 2021 was an absolutely horrible phase of my life. There wasn't any necessary like drama or like heartbreak or anything, but my mental health was super bad and I lost hope in a lot of things. I like wasn't doing my social media, I wasn't really doing much with my life apart from being depressed. And obviously here I'm writing that as soon as I came back to my last year at uni, everything got better. I'm so grateful that I'm finally motivated to journal again. She's right there, because I'm doing it every day now. I've lived out at uni alone for 2 whole months so far, and a lot has happened. My life has changed massively. Right now, this morning is a turning point for me. Everything finally feels like it's going to be okay, and everything will work out. Oh, this is crazy, okay. There are quite a few negative entries in here. We're just not gonna go into that. Okay, now I'm gonna try and find an entry from this year just so you guys can kind of see the difference in how I write now. Okay, so I'll read you my entry from Saturday, 1st of January, 2022. Literally, there's no like Dear Diary written in this. It's like in bullet point form, very short and concise. Depending on the day, sometimes it changes. And I literally just wrote what I accomplished today and then bullet points. I did my full morning routine and finished that by 9 o'clock in the morning. I went out and had a breakfast date with friends. I filmed 3 quality TikToks. I started marketing courses. I made a healthy vegetable-based dinner. I filmed a brand new YouTube video and edited it. And then I also spent some quality time alone and read a book. What a productive day. And then I wrote a few things I'm grateful for. And on this day, I wrote my platform on social media, my health, my knowledge, and my grandparents. And then underneath this, I write today's takeaways slash lessons. Waking up earlier makes you 10 times more productive. TikTok videos take up a lot of time, so make sure you're still waking up early. Be authentic in everything. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Also, let me know what you guys would like to see. If you want to have a chat, make any video requests, you can always DM me because I always reply on Instagram. Links are all in the description. So yeah, let me know if you guys are gonna start journaling and if this video helped you. I would love to hear all about it. And I will see you guys in my next video next week. Bye.